Kenneth G. Hasty Raw. In 3, 2, 1.
Hi, everybody. Kenneth G. Hasty back again. Today we're talking about selling to their specifications. So if you haven't been watching any of my videos yet, there's a series of videos. I try to get one out every day, as a matter of fact, to help business owners and salespeople to be more successful and make more sales, make more money, etc. I do that as kind of a way of giving back for all of my years in sales and sales management, executive sales management, entrepreneurialism, etc. And I'm also a business growth consultant. So, you know, if you want to talk about consulting, you can get a hold of me on kennethghasty.com or kennethghasty@gmail.com. So right now, let's talk about selling to their specifications. I learned a hard lesson years ago. I'm going to tell you a little story, tell you about it. I was a new salesperson, really anxious to please and, you know, excited about every opportunity. And I worked for a water well company. So we sold pumps and water well equipment, you know, for wells. And we got a bid in from the state. And I open it up, and it's really formal. Like, oh my gosh, what a great opportunity. And, you know, you sit there and you think, well, what price should I be? And, you know, maybe too much. I'm going to leave too much money on the table. Or, you know, I'm going to be too much and somebody else will beat me. You know, we had a number of competitors. So I went ahead and I worked with the manager at the time. We wrote up, you know, the bid. But our specifications were slightly off. You know, in pumps, they work with curves and things. And you know, our GPM might have been a little, gallons per minute might have been a little bit off, or our, you know, et cetera, et cetera. But, you know, fairly close. So I'd get the closest one I could find for it. And then I'd go in and, you know, we go in when they open the bid. So ceremoniously, the state purchasing agent's there, and there's a handful of competitors in there, and it's like, you know, he's opening the bids and looking ahead, and he goes, well, we've awarded this bid to XYZ company because, you know, the price was reasonable and they were, you know, within our specifications. I was like, crap, you know. So, all right, so a month or two goes by, same thing. We get another opportunity. Well, this is great. I'm going to go back in again. And sit back in, and same thing again. It's like, well, this was more in the specifications, and the price was right, so we're going to award it to ABC company. And I was like, crap. And so I was looking back over. I got back to my office, and I was looking at these bids, and I realized that there were engineers who wrote up these specs because, you know, when you're in water well, does it really matter if you got 10 more gallons coming through, if you already got 300 coming through or less? But somebody has written that into the specs, so that's what the people that purchase go by. So I got kind of an idea, an epiphany, if you will. I went back and I looked at who the engineer was who wrote the specs, and it happened to be the same person on both bids. So then I surmised that this guy must be the guy that they're using to write up the specs. So I look him up, and I find out he's not too far away. So I dropped in on him. I came by with a box of donuts, and I just said, hey, Kenneth G. Hasty, I'm a water well guy, and, you know, I know you do lots of things, and water well is probably not your main thing, but I'm an expert in such things, and I can help you if you're, you know, when you're writing the specs, help make sure you get what you need. He goes, oh, that'd be great. You know, let's, in fact, I'm working on one right now. So what I did is I got him to write the specs in such a way that only my pump fit those specs and made it as specific as possible. And so then when I went back to the next time we bid and all that, and we went back and, you know, ceremoniously opens it up, guess who got the bid? That's right. Guess who got every bid after that? That's right. My competitors had no idea how I was doing that, but I was just nailing it. And so point being is, you know, sometimes the specs may not be the specs. This is true not only with engineers, but anybody that writes a purchase order, or basically a request for purchase, RFP, in a big company, in the government, doesn't matter. Somebody initiates it. Somebody's going to be the end user, and they have to communicate their wants and their needs to purchasing, but purchasing makes the decision, so they get save the money, and they have a purchasing department, you know, and such. So even universities. So what I learned to do when I get a bid, or when I know somebody, you know, is you know, put out for proposals and things, I learned to find out who the originator of it is. Not the purchasing agent, but the actual person, the actual end user. And then I would visit with them and I'd say, what are you really looking for here? And oftentimes I was able, you know, it was what the purchasing agent was asking for was not what this person really was looking for. And so I was able to go in and then I would find out exactly what they had, find out what I had, if I did. But if I had something that fit their need exactly, then I would go to the purchasing agent and say, hey, I want to keep you out of a situation here. You don't want to buy something nobody's going to use, right? Let me tell you, I sat down with so-and-so. Here's what they're really looking for. I happen to have it. And I've gotten a lot of business that way. And especially if I brought donuts or cookies into the purchasing office or finance office. Now, also, sole source. That's the holy grail of working within specs and bids. If you become the only one who can do it, the only company that has it, or whatever reason, that nobody, because they try to bid 2-3 at least to get a best price. But if there's nobody that has what you have, it doesn't really matter how many bids they put out. And so if you can get in a situation to convince them or to actually be the sole source, the only place they can get it, then it doesn't go out for bid. Then it just comes to you. The purchase order comes right to you. So that's my advice for today. So selling to their specs may not be their specs. And if you can become sole source, that's a wonderful thing. So find out who actually needs it and go find them and then see if you can then become an intermediary to help them get what they want, especially if it's coming from you. So Kenneth G. Hastie, kennethghastie.com, kennethghastie@gmail.com. And I have a book on selling that I wrote. You can get almost anywhere, Barnes & Noble, Amazon, etc., and also ebooks. It's called 77 Seconds to Sales Success. And that's it for today. So hopefully we'll see you again tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, forward, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.